There's a couple of different answers to that. Melanoma does seem to be unique in terms of solid tumor malignancies in just being a very immunogenic tumor. For years, melanoma was treated with interleukin-2 and interferon alpha when other tumors generally weren't very responsive to these immune therapies. And part of the reason is that melanoma triggers the immune system in a way that, you know, other tumors don't to the same extent. But the other way, other respect in which it's leading the way is that in testing novel immunotherapies, PD-1, ipilimumab, ipilimumab was tested in melanoma and even today is the only cancer in which it's approved for human beings. And then combination immunotherapies like ipi-nivo or ipilimumab plus nivolumab, you know, melanoma is the cancer in which it was first tested, and then now I know it is approved in kidney cancer and it's being tested in other cancers, in lung cancer as well. But I think because of the fact that it's so immunogenic, I feel like the signal is stronger for immunotherapies in melanoma, and especially for novel checkpoints or novel immune system manipulation. I think melanoma still is a good place to test because unfortunately, even today, with all these immunotherapies, it's not like every single patient with melanoma has a response, or even of the patients who have a response, the response is durable. For many patients, you're talking transient responses which will eventually progress. And so I think there's a lot of room for improvement in melanoma. And you know, I that's my plea for continuing trials in melanoma.